Hello, I am Dr. Debolina. I am a consultant dermatologist. I do practice in Jhargram, Midnapur and Kharagpur, and presently I am attached to Jhargram District Hospital. Today I will be focusing on few points on acne. So what acne is? Acne is a chronic inflammatory disorder of the skin of the bilosebaceous unit comprising of the sebaceous gland and the hair follicle. Acne can be presented in two forms. One is the inflammatory and another one is the non-inflammatory. In inflammatory acne, we have the papule, pustule, nodule and cysts, and in non-inflammatory acne, we have the comedons. Again, comedons can be classified into two. One is the closed comedons, what we call the whiteheads. Another one is the open comedons, what we call is the blackheads. Now, acne can be classified into two categories depending on the age. One is the adolescent acne, another one is the post-adolescent or the adult acne. In adolescent acne, the age of onset is in between 12 to 24 and it is centrofacial. It has minimal role of hormonal influences and the most predominant lesion is the comedon. While in post-adolescent or adult acne, it predominantly occurs in women of age group more than 25, they mainly occur over the jaw lines and the neck areas, and they have hormonal influences, and they present it as painful, deep-seated nodules, pustules, abscesses and cysts. Now, the contributing factors. If we really say about diet, it is still controversial and unproven. But still, data say that some foods with high glycemic index like white bread, pasta, french fries, and food like skimmed milk, they really have a role in acne aggravation. Other contributing factors are stress factor, genetic factors, endocrinal factors, smoking. So quit smoking and it kills. Another factor is the drugs. The drugs that commonly cause acne or the monomorphic lesions are topical and oral corticosteroids. They are there are isoniazids or rifampicin like antitubercular drugs, antidepressants, most commonly the lithium, then anticonvulsants, etc. Now coming to the treatment portion. In treatment, we have the oral and topical therapies. In oral modalities, we have oral antibiotics like cyclines, doxycycline, tetracycline. We have macrolides like erythromycin. We have azithromycin. But the major drawback is the drug resistance. While in other oral remedies, we have the zinc therapy, we have hormonal therapy with OCPs and low dose corticosteroids, we have retinoids like acitretin and isotretinoin. In topical modalities, again we have antibiotics like dapsone, nicotinamide, clindamycin. We have topical retinoids, we have topical preparation of benzoyl peroxide, azelaic acid, alpha hydroxy acid, salicylic acid, etc. Now, apart from this oral and topical medication, we have other modalities like phototherapy, photodynamic therapy, laser therapy, and we have aesthetics procedures like microdermal abrasion, we have subcision, chemical peeling, etc. Now, it's the time to break the myths. Number one, home remedies, do they really work? No, it's a big no because there is no such evidence-based data. Number two is scrubber. Cleanser do really have a role, but scrubbers not, because scrubber may cause irritation to your skin, may damage the skin integrity. And number three is the bowel habit. There is nothing to deal with your constipation, your dysentery or diarrhea. So this is all about acne in a nutshell. It is not only a cosmetic disorder, but also a disorder that can lead to psychological issues like anxiety, depression, like social phobia, etc. So it's a big responsibility from our side to treat your acne effectively early to give a better healing. So last of all, acne does not make you ugly. You are still beautiful. Stay confident, stay beautiful, consult your doctor, trust your doctor. Stay home, stay safe.
To book an appointment with a cosmetologist or a dermatologist in your area, please visit www.skinandhairacademy.in.